Aladdin Creations.
Friends, welcome to another question and answer time video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. Today question about practical hematology. We all know almost all hospitals in the world use most efficient and accurate automated hematology analyzers for complete blood count test. But still, sometimes we have to move these advanced hematology analyzers to manual fluid staining method. But why? Let's see what is the correct answer is. As we all know, the most commonly performed test in clinical hematology laboratories is complete blood count test. Currently available automated hematology analyzers are capable of performing complete blood count test efficiently, reliably and cost effectively. But however, a microscopic examination of an appropriately prepared and well-stained blood smear or manual cell counts are necessary and clinically useful in a number of circumstances and for a variety of reasons. Usually, blood smear or manual count are performed to verify the automated platelet count if it is flagged by the analyzer or if it is lower than the lowest limit of the referent range. Also, it is necessary to perform a blood smear scan or manual count if any of measurement parameters of complete blood count are flagged by the analyzer. Example, when the analyzer generates any one or more following flags: platelet clump, giant or large platelets, red cell fragments and white cell associated flags such as blast, atypical cells, immature granulocytes and left shift. And to determine whether the automated differential result that is flagged by the analyzer is reliable and reportable. In some cases with clinical suspicion of EDTA-induced thrombocytopenia. Even if there is no any of above indications, still we have to do manual count and blood smear scan, which serve as a quality control tool in verifying the results generated by automated analyzers. As a summary, manual count and blood smear scanning allow for us to identification of abnormal, immature, atypical cells if present, allow for recognition of clinically significant morphologic abnormalities which the analyzers are incapable of either flagging or detecting and identifying. Also, we can use it as quality control tool. Well friends, I hope you guys enjoy this video and gain some knowledge. So every weekend I release this kind of interesting medical laboratory science and medical related question and answer type of videos. So don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with my latest videos. Thank you.